Hello everyone, welcome to this special edition of CGTN. We are broadcasting live in the eastern Chinese city of Tianjin. Today I would like to bring you to a Saltern. But what is a Saltern? It's a place where sea salt is manufactured and produced. Every day, the salt that you use, the table salt that you can't live without, is produced here.
我们制盐呢，实际按照我们的制盐工艺来说呢，一共分四步。 第一步呢，就是蜡槽。
Basically, that means channeling the seawater through the tubes over here into the pools.
第二步呢，就是制卤，就是利用太阳能和风能把这个卤水里面含的水分蒸发掉，然后逐步的浓缩。到第三步呢，就是结晶，就是你看到这个区域。
What about the fourth step?
第四步主要就是授盐操作了。那盐结晶以后，咱们就可以看。我想尝一下。
我不能分辨它鲜味和咸味是什么区别。实际上是咱们这里产的海盐啊，就是因为刚才您看到了，就是我那个结晶池里不有食盐菌吗？它里面含有一定的胡萝卜素，还有一些其他的氨基酸和微生物。OK，
对于这个盐提现是有一定的益处。
Hello guys, I am Cao Bing. I'm currently at the Museum of Changlu Han'gu.
可以看一下这些盐板是打在这个盐的外包装上。如果 在包装上没有这些盐板，就被视为那个私盐。有盐板就是当然是那个国家这个允许贩卖的盐。So
what role did salt play in the Chinese history?
盐不仅仅是那个调味品，同时在中国古代还是非常重要的税收。作为当时这个政府的第二大税收啊，它主要是干什么用的？作为这个政府开支，养军队以及去公益事业。 这性质有点像咱们现在的国企一样，就是如果盐税能得到保证，就基本实现当时所谓的国家的这个基本运作。
And this is a very small shop just to showcase that how salt is transformed into different qualities over there. And this is a monkey, actually, it's a monkey king. And I'm so impressed that salt can be made into this shape over here. I think there should be a mold involved in the making of it. Also different colors is tainted. That is amazing. Yeah. I'm so surprised to find out that salt actually can be made into such a brick for animals, for the livestock to lick so that they can take in the minerals that they need. And I'm so honored that today I would be allowed to walk around and to see how salt is produced and how salt is made into different commodities and also very important part of it, that's the history of salt. Stay tuned with Tides of Change Season 3. Bye-bye.